What makes any show or any program permissible or not permissible to watch? The screen that you're watching me through right now is the same screen which, if you tune into a different channel, it can present whatever. So the contents of the program. Maybe the narration is great, like narrating the story of whoever. But how about the actors? How about the actresses? Do we have women not wearing hijab? Do they play the kind of music in the background? And they stuff the poison in the honey? Then in this case, I don't care what is the series called. Okay? So there are many factors that determine, not simply because it is said it's a series or a movie about Prophet Muhammad or about any of the companions. This is one thing that I like to clarify in the beginning. The second thing is that who acts and plays the role of Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu anhu? An actor. I don't know who is he. But isn't he the same actor who acts in other plays and with other actresses and kissing and hugging and playing whatever is good and whatever is bad? How could a person like that represent Amir al-Mu'mineen Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu anhu? Okay, what is the alternative then? What is the alternative? You know, whenever we were young and we were taught those stories in the form of narration or a bedtime story, or I read it in a novel, in a book, like Men Around the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I was already able to develop the visualization of Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu anhu and those who are around him, because the point was made and the goal was achieved. But if you think that, well, in order to introduce Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu an to our youth, then we produce something like that. I haven't seen the series. I didn't see any of its episodes. And perhaps I should have a chance to watch it. But I mentioned some guidelines based on we determine whether it is halal or haram to attend something like that. Jazakallahu khairan.